शिरसा पादौ प्रणम्य प्रांजलिः तमभाषता। फोल्डिंग हिज हैंड्स ही स्टार्टेड स्पीकिंग। उद्धव उवाच देवदेवेश योगेश पुण्यश्रवणकीर्तन संहृत्यै तत्कुलं नूनं लोकं संध्यक्ष्यते भवान् विप्रशापं समर्थोऽपि प्रत्यहन्न यदीश्वरः नाहं तवाङ्घ्रिकमलं क्षणार्थमपि केशव त्यक्तुं समुत्सहे नाथ स्वधाम नय मामपि। देवदेवेश योगेश पुण्यश्रवणकीर्तन संहृत्यै तत्कुलं नूनं लोकं संध्यक्ष्यते भवान् विप्रशापं समर्थोऽपि प्रत्यहन्न यदीश्वरः। See, everybody has got a view to express. When a disciple comes to you and addresses you, understand that he has got his own sovereign heart, sovereign mind, and sovereign views and needs. So he comes and says in this manner, Deva Devesha Yogesha Punyashravana Kirtana. So many epithets are used about Krishna. And everyone will use such epithets suited to his own taste, need and occasion. Deva Devesha, you are the Lord of all the Devas. Yogesha, you also are the Lord of Yoga. Yoga Chakravarti you are. Punyashravana Kirtana. Punyashravana Kirtana. It's a wonderful epithet. You are such a holy person, such a wonderful, splendorous person, that anything to hear about you, anything to be sung about you, all these are extremely holy and purifying. My dear Lord, you are such a wonderful person. Anybody who is devoted to you, either who sings your praises or listens to your glories, all of them will feel immense, immense punya, unsurpassable by any other means. Devadevesha yogesha punyashravana kirtana samhrityai tatkulam noonam logam sandhyakshyade bhavan. What did I hear? Samhrityai tatkulam noonam logam sandhyakshyade bhavan. The whole kula, your dynasty, you are going to destroy. After destroying the whole of your dynasty, Logam Sandhyakshyade Bhavan, this world also you are going to abandon. You are not merely going to abandon Dwaraka, you are going to abandon the entire earth and world, but after destroying your family. And for destruction of your family, what have you done? Not that you are going to take a cane, sword, spear, etc., chakra, no. Viprashapam samarthovi pratyahanna yadishwarah. Somehow the children played. They went to the Maharshis and they spoke something wrong, something blatant lie, and they got something in the form of curse. You could have yourself gone and spoken to them that it is in light-hearted things. Please excuse them, and they should have been given some kind of deliverance, atonement. But you decided, no, let it be, let it be. You had every chance and power and glory to undo what they have done, but you decided not to do it. So you are very clear that you should destroy your family. Viprashapam samarthovi pratyahanna yadishwaraha. Although you have got the power, glory and splendor to undo any kind of a curse coming from anybody, whosoever it is, you have decided not to employ it. Devadevesha yogesha punyashravana kirtana samhrityai tatkulam noonam lokam santyakshyate bhavan viprashapam samarthovi pratyahanna yadishwarah. My dear Lord, you have decided to depart from this world. Once you have decided, nobody can change it. So I am sure you will be going. But I have something to tell you. I have been associated with you intimately for so many decades. If you are 125 years, correspondingly and parallelly, I am also old. And All along I have been associated with you. Now that you are going, you have decided to go, I have something to say. Naham tavangri kamalam kshanardham apikeshava tiktum samutsahe natha swadhama nayamamabi. Naham, I will not be able to. Tavangri kamalam, your lotus feet, kshanardham apikeshava tiktum. To keep away from your lotus feet, even for half a kshana, half a second, I have no strength at all. Even if I want to do it, I will not be able to do it. Tektum samutsahe natha. I have been associated with you so intimately all these decades. Now suddenly you say, you are going away. What shall I do? I cannot keep away from your feet even for half a second. Not that I don't want to. I don't have the strength to do so. Tektum samutsahe natha. To abandon your feet and still be breathing and living, it is not possible for me. Therefore, I only have one prayer to make. You have decided to go, and I am sure you will go. Please take me also along wherever you go. This one prayer you should sanction before me. Swadhama nayamamavi. Take me to your abode. This is what he says. My dear viewers, if you are devotees, this should be the one prayer in your heart, not anything else. When you go to a holy place or a temple or stand in front of a picture or a deity, never think of any other prayer. This is the one sloka. Millions and millions of devotees in India or even outside, they congregationally sing. This is their heart's prayer. We know the world has to be left today or tomorrow. We have not come here to be. We have come here to go. Never be here. I don't think any one of you has had your birth optionally here. Somehow when you looked at, you found a body for you. Your mother says she delivered it. The father says, I am also a part in it. The mother introduces the father and the father introduces the mother. And we accept it. Our birth is not optional. We have somehow found ourselves in this world. And from this world, we only have to go. When we cannot say. Before going, we must have attained our fulfillment. And this fulfillment will come to you only through devotion. Only through God, only through the self, only through the realization, personal, inner, intuitive realization. There is no other way for it. So this is the prayer. Take me along with you. We always go to the temple and pray to the Lord. My dear Lord, give me a house to live. My dear Lord, get my daughter properly married so that I don't have to worry about her. Give me two children who will give me the last water. This is all your prayer. Very foolish prayers. Before the Lord, why should you ask for anything? If at all you should ask, make a confession like this. My dear God, I cannot keep away from you half a second even. Take me along with you. Make me your part or join me and be my part. Let us live together. Dance together, smile together, walk together, eat together. No separation. This should be the prayer that you have. Arjuna was in the Kurukshetra battlefield. Unable to stand in the chariot, he had already sat, laying down his weapons, bow and arrow. And in a state of utter distress and discomfiture, he uttered the words, Karpanya dosho bhagata swabhavaha Prachamitvam dharmasam uthacheta yachreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme shishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam. I would like you to compare and contrast what Arjuna confessed in the battlefield and what Uddhava confesses here sitting close to Krishna in the Dwaraka Rajadhani. Just imagine the two situations. There, Arjuna is asking, instruct me on the path of Shreyas. Here he says, take me along with you to wherever you go. This is the one prayer generally uttered by millions of devotees in India and outside, especially when there is a congregation of devotees and Srimad Bhagavata or a similar scripture is described, is narrated. This shloka is often recited. Many people utter this shloka standing in front of their beloved Lord. I will recite it and a few people from the ashram will also follow me. My intention is that after I recite, all my viewers also should be with attention with closed palms. You must be able to recite it. I will give time. In your place, our devotees here who are standing on my right will also be reciting. I will recite it altogether 2 times so that you have enough opportunity to learn it. This is verse number 43 of the 6th chapter of the 11th Skandha of Srimad Bhagavata. Naham tavangri kamalam.
Naham tavangri kamalam.
Naham tavangri kamalam.
Naham tavangri kamalam.
Kshanardham api keshava.
Kshanardham api keshava.
Tyaktum samutsahe natha.
Tyaktum samutsahe natha.
Swadhamanaya mamapi.
Swadhamanaya mamapi.
Naham tavangri kamalam.
Naham tavangri kamalam.
Kshanardham api keshava.
Kshanardham api keshava.
Tyaktum samutsahe natha.
Tyaktum samutsahe natha.
Swadhamanaya mamapi.
Swadhamanaya mamapi.
Naham tavangri kamalam.
Naham tavangri kamalam.
Kshanardham api keshava.
Kshanardham api keshava.
Tyaktum samutsahe natha.
Tyaktum samutsahe natha.
Swadhamanaya mamapi.
Swadhamanaya mamapi.
Swadhamanaya mamapi. The great holy text composition called Srimad Bhagavatam has become so popular in our land because of these touching scenes and narrations. Just imagine, we have come to the last part of Krishna's life. The entire Dwaraka is going to be swallowed by the ocean. All people are going to be wiped off. And the last message of Krishna is being sought by Uddhava with a confession of this nature. Can you imagine? What is the strength, the depth, and the integrity of the devotee and the devotional culture of this great holy land? I would like you to spend enough time to imagine about the gravity of the whole situation, how touching the scene is. A devotee cries out to say, take me also when you go. We have fathers, mothers, so many parents are there, children are there, husbands and wives are there, so many are there. Have you found any occasion when any family member will ask the father or the mother, the husband or the wife, you are going, I am not able to keep away from you, please take me also along with you. Only a devotee can say this, and that too in front of a Mahatma or the Sadguru. In no other relationship you will find something of this nature. Tava vikriditam Krishna nrinam parama mangalam karna piyusham aswadya tyajatyanyaspraham janaha shayasanadanasthana snana kridashanadishu katham tvam priyamatmanam vayam bhaktastyajemahi Tvayopabhuktasraggandha vasolankara charchidaha uchishta bhojino dasaha tavamayam jayemahi vatarasana yarshayaha shramanaha udhvamandhinaha ब्रह्माख्यं धामते यान्ति शान्ताः सन्यासिनोमलाः वयं त्विह महायोगिन् भ्रमन्तः कर्मवर्त्मसु त्वद्वार्तया तरिष्यामः तावकैः दुस्तरं तमः स्मरन्तः कीर्तयन्तस्ते कृतानि गदितानि च गत्युस्मिते क्षणक्ष्वेलि यन्नृलोकविडम्बनम्. दीस् आर् द फ्यू वर्सेस् उद्धव एड्स् justifying what he has said as a compliment and a supplement to his confession. Naham tavangrikamalam kshanardhamabhi keshava tektum samutsahe natha swadhama nayamamabhi. For Uddhava to make this confession, there is a lot of background. This you should understand. Tava vikriditam krishna nrinam paramamangalam karna piyushama swadhya त्यजति अन्यस्पृहां जनः. तव विक्रीडितं कृष्ण नृणां परममङ्गलं. वाट् एवर् यु आर् लार्ड् हरि परमकल्याणनिधि लार्ड् हरि. वाट् एवर् यु इन् द एम्बाडिमेण्ट् आफ् ए ह्यूमन् वित् ए ह्यूमन् एम्बाडिमेण्ट्. वाट् एवर् यु हेव् डन् हियर् आफ्टर् युवर् बर्त् आर् ईवन् बिफोर् देट् तव विक्रीडितं फोर् यु इट्स् ए स्पोर्ट्फुल् डिस्प्ले. कृष्ण नृणां paramamangalam. This is what showers supreme felicity, supreme auspiciousness for all the human beings upon this earth. Your whole life is a blessing, an open and a continuous benediction upon humanity. Karnapiyushamaswadhya tyajati anyaspraham janaha. More and more this nectar is received by the ears. Karnapiyusham. This is nectarine to the ears. Whatever you have done, when it is narrated, when it is heard, when it is remembered, karna piyushamaswadhya tyajati anyaspraham janaha. The more and more the descriptions and narrations of your life and exploits are heard, these nectarine words, as they enter into the mind sheds all the desire for worldly things. Tyajati anyaspraham janaha. Let it be a foolish man, an ignorant man. Let him be a dacoit. Let him be an immoralist. Let him be the celibate and ascetic. Whoever it is, the mind almost is the same for everyone. It is a natural product. Like the biological body, the panchabhutas, the mind also is a product of nature. When that natural product called the mind goes on receiving the impressions of all these narrations in itself, all of them get dissolved into the mind, and the mind, because of the delight and the exaltation, the exhilaration, the ecstasy these words produce, it immediately sheds all the desires for other things. Tava vikriditam krishna nrinam paramamangalam karna piyushamaswadhya tyajati anyaspraham janaha shayyasanadanasthana snana kridashanadishu कथं त्वां प्रियमात्मानं वयं भक्तास्त्यजेमहि. I don't know whether normally a wife makes this kind of an address to the husband. Shayyasanadanasthana snanakridasanadishu. Shayya, in the bed. Asana, in your seat. Atana, when you travel. Wherever you sit. Snana, while taking bath. Krida, while playing. Asana, while eating. In all these things, I have been closely associated with you. There is nothing that was excluded for me. I was not kept away. Katham tvam priyamatmanam vayam bhaktastyajemahi. How can we keep you away? Priyamatmanam, you are so beloved. You are our very self. Such a person, how can you keep you away in all these things? Whether we are lying, traveling, eating, sitting, playing, anything that we do, we cannot keep you away at all. So you are so beloved. Not only that, you are our very self. Vayam bhaktastyajemahi katham. How can we, the devotees, how can we abandon you? Arjuna's question was, katham bhishma maham sankhe dronam cha madhusudana. How can I fight Bhishma and Drona? They are to be worshipped the moment I see them. I should fall in their feet. Here also he is asking a katham. How? What is Uddhava's Katham? Uddhava's Katham is Vayam Bhaktastya Jemahi. We are your humble, loving, beloved devotees. We only know to love you, adore you, to hear about you, to think about you, to delight and exult in whatever we find about you. Katham tuam priyam atmanam, tuam priyam atmanam, you who are the most beloved, who are our very self, vayam bhaktastya jemahi, being loving devotees, how can we think of abandoning you at all, my dear Lord? Tvayobhukta sragandha vasolankara charchidaha uchishta bhojino dasaha tava mayam jayemahi. It is by virtue of your own maya, inscrutable power, that the whole universe is revolving, revolving, revolving. Everything is cyclic here. The earth itself is spinning on its own axis. It circumambulates the sun. The moon circumambulates the earth. Maybe the sun circumambulates some other planet. All this paraphernalia, conglomeration, all this rigmarole, it is all taking place only because of your maya. And that maya is having a strong hold on our mind. On our mind. Now I hear that you are going. I am now saddled. I am not able to think of me away from you. What shall I do? What shall I do? There is the pang of separation. There is the impossibility of my keeping away. Why? Tvayobhukta sragandha vaso alankara charchitaha. Whatever you have used, next day I was using. Uchishta bhojinaha. Whatever you have left over after food, because of my fondness for you, I used to deliciously eat it. So much of physical intimacy and fondness I have with you. I am your dasa. I am not your master. I am not a friend. I am not even a devotee. I am actually a dasa, a humble servant of yours. Tvayobhukta sragantha vasolankara charchidaha. The wonderful, uncontrollable, inscrutable power called maya, which you have cast over the whole universe for me to overcome this. The means is only this physical and intimate association with you. Using the things which you have used, I will put on my body, I will eat. And by that means, I carry you, I bring you, I preserve you, I cherish you in my heart. Uchishta bhojino dasaha tava mayam jayemahi. This is the only way for us to overcome your maya. Vatarasana yarshayaha shramanaha urthvamandhinaha brahmakhyam dhamate yanti shantaha sanyasino amalaha. Maybe there are ascetic people, austere stalwarts in the country. They have a very pure mind. My mind is not so pure, Krishna. I belong to an altogether different category. Vatarasana, vatarasana. Maybe they are able to eat even air, breathe air, and that is sufficient for them. They are maharshis, shramanaha, urdhvamandhinaha. They are able to be urdhvaredas. This is a typical expression where the vital fluid is flowing upward. It is all getting converted into brilliance and tejas. They don't waste it or use it because they are ascetic people, unmarried people. Urdhvamandhinaha. Brahmakhyam tamadeyanti shantaha sanyasinomalaha. They are given to the sannyasa way of life, ascetic way of life. And no desire whatsoever is overpowering their mind, deluding them. Te yanti brahmakhyam tamade. They may be able to go to that brahmakhyam, that brahmic abode, maybe by a process of contemplation, inner absorption, that self-absorption they are able to achieve. They are very powerful, very powerful. They have no children. They are not married. They are away from the world. They are away from the household. They are surrounded by trees, birds, and reptiles of the forest. So they have nothing to be attracted to, allured by, fall in love with. Nothing is there. So they are very safe. Don't think that I am belonging to that category. Vayam dviha mahayogin brahmantaha karmavartmasu tvadvartaya tarishyamaha tavagaihi dustaram tamaha. Vayam dviha mahayogin Brahmandaha, Karmavartmasu, people like me, people like us are here in this world. Hey, Mahayogin, Brahmandaha, Karmavartmasu. We are all rambling, meandering in the world of activities, household activities. We are connected with blood relationship, matrimonial relationship, friend circle, societal obligations, religious obligation, panchamahayajnas we have to perform. Many things are there. Tvat vartaya tarishyamaha tavagaihi dustaram tamaha. Tvat vartaya tarishyamaha tavagaihi dustaram tamaha. For us the only way is to think about you, to sing about your glory, to chant and recite your names, to listen to the narrations about you. That is the only way. Tarishyamaha tavagaihi dustaram tamaha. In order to overcome the sharp ignorance cast by your tamoguna, this is the only way for us. So we are in your association. If this association is cut away or denied, we are lost forever. Understand that we are not ascetics. We cannot do the tapasya, the penance that they are given to. Smarandaha kirtayandaste kirdani gadidani ja gatyusmide kshanakshveli yen riloho kavidambanam. Smarandaha kirtayandaste kirdani gadidani ja.